Morning everybody. As I was saying in the last video when I was fixing up the floor, we're doing our shearing today. We're shearing the Dohne lambs and the White Suffolk crosses. So we just started. We've done about 4 or 5 sheep. So change here. Dad's on the table slicing as usual. So we're pretty much right into it. So I'll set the camera up and we'll keep going.
Thank you.
Alright everybody, we're about halfway through the Doonies at the moment, and I just thought I'd grab Dad for a sec. He's just classing the wall as he usually does. We've spoken a lot about what goes on when you're classing the adult sheep when you're classing their wool, but we've never really spoken about the lamb's wool, so I'll just get Dad to talk about that quick.
G'day viewers, we're doing the lambs as Cam said. It's totally different to what we're doing when we do the adult sheep, but their wool's more developed and it's got more fibres holding together. Lamb's wool just falls apart when you pick it up, so Cam's got to pick it up with a set of boards, put it on the table. We have a tarp or a covering on the table so the lamb's wool don't, good lamb's wool don't fall through. All that stuff under the table is short sleeping down the valley and the lake. Cam's got to pick it up with the floors because you can't pick it up like a grown sheep fleece. Anyway, you call it sorting lambs. I'm putting it into three different grades here. This one's not a bad fleece to show you on. That's what I'm calling 3A lambs because it's nice and white and it's reasonable length. And that's our 3A lamb line in there, because it's about the best we've got at the minute for length and cleanness and whatever. And over here, I made this little bit of a butt. Our 2A lambs, this is a bit shorter. As you can see, I'll get a bit halfway. See, that's a little bit shorter than that last stuff we looked at. Probably a bit of an overkill, but if you put too much short stuff in with your good line of wool, it sort of downgrades a little bit. And to get all that stuff under the table, it's all the short stuff that I chuck off under here, whatever and whatever. So that's basically about it. We're getting a bit of water stain wool in with this as well, so I'm taking that out. Naturally you're looking for all the skin bits and whatever that comes along, so you've got to do the best you can. It's a bit hard with lambs because the shearers like shearing lambs and they go pretty quick. That's how they make their money. Alright, I'll catch you on the next one. Yeah, no, you're right, mate.
Right now, so that grip there that I let out, that was the last of the Dohnes. Now we're up to the White Suffolk crosses. So we're gonna make a start on those. Won't get them done today. There'll probably be a handful to do tomorrow, which I'll probably won't film any of that tomorrow. Won't worry about that, because it won't be enough to really warrant it. But yeah, we'll start the White Suffolks now.
I think it'll kill me, I think it will.
Fuck it,
We just finished for the day, ended up finishing all those White Suffolk lambs. We ended up just, chain smashed it out. They shore a little bit easier. I've got Dad here. I'm just going to wrap up the video, just sort of give his overview of what he reckoned about wool and the day and all that sort of crap. So I'll give you over to him.
Yeah, g'day viewers. Been a big day for an old man. Shane done a pretty good job getting them all done today on his own. Ended up with a bit more wool than what we thought. The White Suffolk over there, well, it's not real flash wool at the best of times, but it's interesting to see what it sells like. We'll sell it privately. A bloke will come and pick it up. So, that didn't look too bad out of the wool. We can get a bit of a shower of rain, a bit of green pick in the paddock, they'll kick along again. So all in all, it wasn't a bad sort of day. Cam done a good job rousing, and glad to finish. See you at the next one.
Alright, so that's pretty much it. The lamb shearing's finished up. We'll shear them again at the end of the year, won't we? When we do the rest of the sheep.
We might shear the Suffolks again before they go to the market.
Well, Dad just said then we might shear the White Suffolk crosses again before we sell them off at market, and then
in September,
and the Doonies they'll just get shorn again with the rest, won't they?
Yeah.
When we do the shearing end of the year, those Dooney lambs will just get shorn with the rest of the mob. So we'll finish up the video there. Thanks all for watching. See you for the next one. Arrow.